Hello students, let's continue our discussion. Next topic in object oriented concept module 3, that is order of execution of the constructor when constructors are called. Okay, the small programming example is given over here. See, once again the multi-level hierarchy is taken. In the previous video we have discussed about the multi-level hierarchy. So multi-level hierarchy is taken here. Three class modules are taken: class A, class B, as well as class T, class C. Class A, which has got a single executable statement, that is constructor of class A, which has got a single executable statement inside A's constructor is written. Then class B, which extends the properties of A, concentrate on the things which I am pointing. That means B is the child class, A is the parent. So observe the constructor body of B. So this prints a single statement inside B's constructor. Then we are creating one more class C, which extends the properties of its parents. For C, B is the parent. For B, A is the parent. Please refer to my previous video. You must have written it in your notebook as well, right? So multi-level hierarchy is established here. One is considered as grandparent, that is A is the grandparent, B is the parent, and A is the child now. A is the grandparent, B is the parent, and C is the child now. So C is the child, which extends the properties of its parent. Its parent is B. Similarly, one printf statement is written inside C's constructor. Fine. And in the main function is included inside another class module. Calling CONS is the name of the file as per this. Calling CONS.java is the file name. Now in this we are creating the object of the subclass. Subclass or child class. C is the child, right? B is its parent, where A is the parent of B. So is the grand, A is the grandparent, B is the parent, C is the child. We are creating the child class object. Once the object is created, constructor should be called, right? Recall the definition of the constructor. So constructors will be called once object is created by this step. Which step? Let me highlight this. So by this step, constructor is called. Which constructors are called? Actually, first C, you are creating the object of C. So you may think that C, constructor of C will be executed first, but please remember, constructor of parent class is automatic. So automatic call for the parent class constructor will be done by the child class or subclass object. So subclass object, what it does is, instead of printing inside C's constructor plus, first it will look for its parent. You can decide that with the help of the whether key extends keyword is available or not. It thinks whether it has got any inherited property. Of course, it has got inherited property from whom? It has got inherited property from B. So it will look into the B's constructor. So before printing the value of B's constructor, what it does, again it follows the same definition, that is, it will look for any inherited property available or not. So inherited property is available, that is A's property is available. Of course, observe here class A, whether it is extending any other property or properties from any other class? No, because it does not uses the extends keyword. So this itself is the parent, grandparent we are referring it to as. So what it does, it is not having any other inherited property. So this now control is there in here. It is positioning into the A's class constructor. So things will be printed, right? So things are printed and control is returned to whom? Control is returned to its child. Who is its child? Its child is class B, right? Control is returned to its child, that is class B. So this statement will be executed inside B's constructor will be executed, and once its execution is completed, it will return the control to the class C, its child. So its child, in the sense, from B to C, control will be returned So what will happen? First, inside is constructor, parent class, that grandparent class constructor will be executed. Then its child constructor will be executed, followed by constructor of C will be executed. Okay, a small programming example, very simple concept as and very important topic as well. Okay, order of execution of the constructor from parent to child. Please remember, always in case of inheritance, parent class constructor will be executed first, followed by child class. Even though you are creating the object of the child, what it does, it will look for inherited property before executing its own constructor, that is child class. Before executing its own constructor, what it does, it will look into the inherited property, its parent property. If anything is derived from its parent, then its parent property will be executed, that constructor property will be executed first, followed by child's own property. So that is the reason why the grandparent here, for C, though B is the parent, you cannot directly have access to, you cannot execute directly the B's constructor contents. Instead, B again has got some inherited property from class A. That is what you can see, which I am pointing. That is the reason why, yeah, A is the supermost class, because this does not inherit anything from any other module. That is the reason why what happens, first this constructor content will be executed, then control will be returned to its child, followed by control will be returned to class C. Fine. That is the reason why we are getting the output like this. If you have any doubt, you ask, note down the program. Okay, let's continue our discussion in the next video. Thank you for